consequences. And I'm going to tell you this, I have a 22-year-old. And so when I was putting this together, it confirmed where she at now. Because we still trying to get to those other places. I think she's still in the early teens and she's 22. So I'm just looking forward to when she gets to this part, judgment and decision making. Watching your brain. So imagine a team who just all they can feel. so we as adults might say, that doesn't even make sense. But you got to think back to the development of a teen's brain and how they process and how they think. And so they're not in a rationalization stage just yet. To us, that would be something crazy. Advice for parents. Respect the power of medicine. And our teens, they do model a lot of things after us. So if in the documentary, it's so sad to see that young lady who lost her daughter. But she herself was addicted to prescriptions. And her daughter, despite seeing what her mother was going through, went down the same path. So that adage of do as I say, not as I do, that doesn't apply anymore. Recognize that all medications, including prescription medications, have risks. And we know that because we watch commercials. How many of you watch a commercial and it may be something for diabetes and the last 2 minutes is the side effects? From blindness to death to this to that to that. And then you got this guy with a smile and going on the stroll, but those side effects, I don't know. Take responsibility for learning how to take a prescription safely and appropriately. And as a parent, if you have a child who needs a prescription, it's your responsibility to read what is on that bottle, what are the side effects, how often it should be taken. You should be involved in administration of those people. Speak to your team about prescription medications or medicines. Encourage your teen to ask you or a doctor about the side effects. Alert your family physician that you're concerned and ask them to speak to your teen about the importance of proper use of prescription medicines. We're working on an opioid prevention program. We're with the Alabama Academy of Pediatrics, and we met with them, and actually what was suggested was also get our dentists involved in the conversation. Because many pediatricians do not prescribe, but we do have dentists do procedures for prescribing more opioids. And so we're going to be bringing them into the conversation as well. And not only your family physician, your pharmacist. When you're at Walmart, CVS, ask those questions to those pharmacists. They will make time for you to answer any questions you may have. Of course, keep prescription medicines in a safe place. Avoid stockpiling them.